Well, he was an extremely special person. I don't think you could find a more humane and more decent and more accomplished person all wrapped into one. He was a devoted family man, as well as being part of a 66-year-long marriage to Lady Anna Cowen, and she was the source of a huge amount of strength for him. He often used to say with a tear in his eye that he looked at his wife with wonder. And that continued from the time he met her as a 17-year-old right through to the time his death after a 66-year marriage. So that was the private man of Sir Zelman, but there was also very much the public man. And if you look at his achievements, I don't think they're surpassed by anyone else in Australia, particularly the diversity and the variety of his achievements. He was a brilliant academic. I mean, he topped Scotch College, where he was Ducks. He then won a Rhodes Scholarship. He then went to Oxford, where he won the Vinerian Scholarship for being the best student at Oxford. And then he came back to be the Dean of the Law School at the University of Melbourne.
At what age?
31.
That's extraordinary.
And what he did, Henry, was that he professionalised and internationalised legal education in Australia. And he built wonderful linkages with big universities overseas, renowned for their legal scholarship, particularly the University of Chicago and Harvard University. And then he was tapped on the shoulder and asked to become the Vice Chancellor of the University of New England, and later the Vice Chancellor of the University of Queensland. So for more than a decade, he led established institutions in Australia. And then came the big request.
Ta-dum!
Ta-dum! 1977, he was asked by Malcolm Fraser, an inspired choice, may I say, to become Governor General. And I told the story today at the funeral, how when he was officially asked to become Governor General, he couldn't make it public for a few weeks. And so what happened was that a Queensland legal professor had come to see him, bringing along a visiting American academic. And the Queensland professor said to Sir Zelman, "Who do you think will become Governor General?" And so Sir Zelman started coughing into his hands, not wanting to give anything away. And then the American academic said, "What superannuated old fool would want that appointment?"
He still kept coughing.
And Zelman was later to say the only issue he had with that academic was that he wasn't superannuated.
Correct.
But he became Governor General, served till 1982, was a brilliant Governor General who brought a touch of healing to the nation after the controversies of Sir John Kerr and the sacking of the Whitlam government. And for that, he will be forever known, and the Australian public will be forever grateful.
And then he went on to back to Oxford.
Correct. He was asked to head his old college, Oriel College, and as a Rhodes Scholar, he was very cognizant of the fact that Cecil Rhodes himself had gone to Oriel College.
And he was the first Rhodes Scholar to head Oriel College.
And he oversaw some big changes there, admitting women, for example, for the first time. He was greatly respected at Oriel, and then he was also the chairman of the British Press Council while in the UK.
That's right.
He came back to Australia. He became chairman of Fairfax newspapers for some years here in Australia. Was very influential in that position in terms of preserving editorial independence. And then he just continued to contribute to public life. He was a key participant in the debates about the Republic.
That's right, he was a Republican.
Well, at the end of the day, he said that he could see the need for having an Australian-born head of state.
And he said it was crystal clear.
He said it was crystal clear.
Too clear.
But he was always distinguished, and he was always measured in his interventions into public debate, and he was never partisan. I think that's a really important message for your listeners about Sir Zelman.
Yeah, well, I'd sum him up as having humour, humility and humanity.
Well, that's a very nice way to sum him up.
Because he was. That's besides his genius. Now, we're going out to the next segment with some more footage, just a little bit, and then coming back with you again to finish off the show and talk about the legacy of Sir Zelman Cowen.
Thank you.
See you in the next segment.
In a practical way, you say the university is there to make a doctor, to make a teacher, to make a lawyer, to make this, to make that. But the university ultimately exists to show, to show what is the noblest thing in man, which is the quality of his mind.
Did you do well at school right from the beginning?
Well, the answer is not conspicuously. Well enough, I think, if you took it overall. But there's one very key point, and it comes quite late in school. I was a Scotch, and I remember being told that I had come first in the state at the Year 12 level. Now, that assumes a great deal of importance in my life, because it said to me that in the academic competition, I can get to the top, not by, if you like, anything innate. I must work very hard, but if I work very hard, I'll get there. That's a central, if you like, staging point in my life. One day, it would have been quite early in 1977, the message was the Prime Minister would like me to come to Canberra to have dinner with him. So we had a very cheerful dinner, and then the Prime Minister said, all right, we'll come into my study and we'll talk. And with his first words, I knew what it was about. He said to me, Sir John Kerr has decided to resign. I said, heavens, maybe it wasn't good heavens that I said. Said in my head, he's asking me to be Governor General. And I can only describe the experience as like being a split atom. One part of it hitting this wall, one part of it hitting the other wall. And that's how it began. It was appropriate for a country like our own to have as its head of state a person who was distinctively an Australian. It suddenly seemed to be crystal clear that that was the right course. And it seems to me crystal clear that now that it's the right course, crystal clear.